when you hold me, your beauty weighs on me. This feeling's too good.
So, this is the beginning of my energy series. We are going to be talking about the root chakra today, which is why I am lighting this root chakra candle. Hi, everybody. So for those of you who have been following me, you know that I've been talking about energy, quantum physics, spirituality, meditation, and right now the chakras specifically. I go over 12 different chakras whenever I do a chakra reading. Right now for this series, we're going to just focus on the 7 main chakras that most people know of. However, I do want to go over the ones that I do talk about. If you were to get a chakra reading from me, it would be the Earth Star Chakra, the Base Chakra, the Sacral Chakra, the Solar Plexus Chakra, Heart Chakra, the Higher Heart Chakra, the Throat Chakra, the Ulta Major Chakra, the Third Eye Chakra, the Crown Chakra, the Soul Star Chakra, and last but not least, the Stellar Gateway Chakra. Now, that's 12. I'm talking about 7, but there are a lot. Starting off, and I am reading from my own notes, so if you see my eyes wander, I've got a little script going on. It's to keep me on track. Whenever you're learning about the chakras, you'll usually see another name associated with it. The root chakras, Sanskrit name is Muladhara. Sanskrit is the primary language of Hinduism and has been used as a philosophical language of in the religions of Hinduism and Buddhism and some other ones, but right now I'm focusing on those two main ones because those are how I learned. To break down the word, Mula means root and Adhara means support or base, therefore giving you a chakra that has to deal with support and foundation. It is the chakra that deals with our primal human needs. It is the first chakra of matter. Now, when I say the first chakra of matter, I hope you went to school and learned about science because we know what matter is. I'm going to bring this back up because we have the Earth Star Chakra, which is much like the root chakra, except it is outside of our material body, much like the Stellar Gateway Chakra and the Soul Star Chakra. There's a lot of different energy vortexes that are outside of us, because you have to remember we are not even a material being. We are a spiritual being embodying a body vessel. The reason why the root chakra is so important is because it sets the tone for your other chakras. When this chakra is unbalanced, it can be a little difficult to balance out the other chakras because this is the chakra of foundation. When I say foundation, I want us to think about the foundation and structure, grounding properties of building a house. You cannot build a strong house and expect it to last without a foundation without spending time on that foundation. How can you expect for your life to last and be strong when you don't take the time to work on your foundation? Grounding along with balance is one of the most important lessons that you must learn when it comes to, doing this thing called life. And when you start to learn about the chakras, you really gotta know how to balance them suckers. No matter the case, we have to trust that things are working out for us and not against us. When you begin to have a connection with the universe, whether you call it God, Mother Nature, or whatever, having some sort of connection to something gives you a sort of peace and love and safety that is needed to once again do this thing called life. It becomes very easy to do that when you start to work on your root chakra. Because like I said, it's your foundation. When you are structured and grounded in who you are, nothing can stop you, literally nothing. Let's dig into some information on keeping a well-balanced Muladhara. These are things that I used myself. I always like to say I am a walking, talking testimony, so hear me out. I'm not gonna tell you things that I haven't tried. When it comes to everything, we know that everything has energy. Everything holds a certain frequency, and that means something, especially right now in my quantum physics, journey. I'm kind of in a moment where I believe that we are frequency. The true essence of who we are is frequency. Frequency being able to literally change and do whatever. But I'm not going to get into that right now. For those of you who have been following me on TikTok, you know whenever I talk about anything spiritual or sometimes religious, I will always try my best to back it by science, specifically quantum physics. So with that being said, crystals, shapes, sound, color, and hand gestures are things that give off energy. Energy is where I'm starting to learn that all of this kind of connects. So energy, if you don't know what energy is by now, I don't know what to tell you. Welcome to the chakra series. Throughout this series, I will go over the meaning of each chakras, how I learned, and how it relates to our life, and how we can balance it through the use of color therapy, sacred geometry, sound therapy, and intentional thought and action. Beginning with color psychology. Color is familiar and comforting. It's one of the first things that we learn as young children, sometimes even before we like read or write. An excerpt from this book that I read called Chakras for Beginners, A Guide to Understanding the Seven Chakras of the Body, says it really well. I'm gonna read it verbatim. The chakra colors are a fascinating aspect of the chakra system that invites some deep contemplation about reality. While the chakras are a subtle energetic phenomenon that current science does not yet fully understand, we can learn about the connection between chakras and colors by reflecting upon the actual physics behind color. Color plays a central role in our lives. We are often not aware of how deeply we are influenced by the colors we live in and with. We choose the colors we wear, the colors of the walls on our home, and the food that we eat, the colors of our plates. Colors influences our mood. The company marketing team sometimes will use the color red because the color red pops out. A fire truck is usually red because it's like, it's kind of like a, hey, pay attention. And it just catches our attention. I was learning about Walmart, which is a supermarket. Anyway, they'll usually put things that you don't need, like snacks and stuff, toward the front. And usually it's a lot of colors that are red because it's trying to grab your attention. It's trying to get you to spend money before you get to the things that you need. Do you see? Color psychology is crazy. The color red is associated with the root chakra, obviously. Red is the color of physical energy, which makes sense because this is the first chakra dealing with physical matter. Spiritually, when we think of red, we are thinking about the energy that has to deal with stability, security, grounding, courage, action, physical and emotional survival. Again, all things that have to do with the root chakra. But what in the hell can I do with color, Imani? You just can't tell me about color and be like, okay, go balance your chakra. No. The law of intention, which is something that I'm working on, and I will be winning a Nobel Prize for the law of intention, speak it into existence, talks about how thoughts create our reality. And if we have an intended thought matched with action, we become the magicians of our own life. And this is what I wish to teach you all. Here's how it works with color therapy. You can grab something like a red shirt, or for example, this is my red robe. I wear this like all the time. I don't care if it's hot, whatever. I got this on. You can put a red shirt on, throw your red robe on in the morning with the intention of creating strong boundaries that day, staying grounded within yourself. Whatever the root chakra has to deal with, that is your intention that you're infusing into the color. Does that make sense? So it's like the color already is giving off a certain frequency matched with your intention, your intentional thought. It'll amplify that energy, and that energy will start to be around you in your life. Another example, I don't have red jasper is a crystal that is connected to the root chakra. This is like the root chakra here, but I got some on here. I also have like black tourmaline that is connected to the root chakra. But right now we're going to talk about red jasper. The properties of red jasper help to ground your energy and to control your emotions. It does many other things, but for right now we're going to focus on those two. Wouldn't it make sense for a crystal that gives off grounding energies to be the color red? Because if the color red is associated with grounding energy, does that make sense? So if red holds a certain type of energy, then having a crystal be red should also allow the crystal to embody and amplify that energy. Okay? When we think of balancing chakras. I want us to think of it as if we have a problem, okay? Kind of like, okay, I need X, Y, and Z to help balance out the equation of my life. X, Y, and Z would be energies that mix well to balance that issue. Think of your life as a math problem. The universe is a big giant math problem, so it would make sense why our little itty bitty life could be a math problem too. What variables can you add to your life? What energies can you add to your life that will balance out an equation, balance out a situation that you're going through? Let's think about sixth grade math right now. I'm just kind of spitballing. This might not make sense, but it kind of does, and I hope it does to y'all. Let's think about the equation y equals mx plus b. In this equation, we have a constant and we have some variables. The constant in our life is us as consciousness. The constant in our life is us as consciousness. We will never not be anything else. I'm gonna say it one more time. The constant in our life is us as consciousness. We deal with constantly changing things that we have to figure out, but we'll always be the same. And I guess in that way, I would say y equals mx plus b because that it talks about the slope of a line and everything. The slope in this case is always moving, constantly changing. But we gotta find out some variables on how to balance that, okay? This might not make sense for the equation, but I'm just talking, okay? Let's call the slope of a root chakra issue, okay? We then need to find out some variables to help find the solution to our issue that will in turn balance out that chakra. In life, we are always searching for things to balance out the constant, which is us, consciousness. In life, we are constantly searching for things to balance out us as consciousness that will make it easier for us to live life, okay? The variables in this case would be whatever energies mix well with the root chakra to keep it balanced. The constant is us. The slope or whatever of the chakra are the variables would be color therapy, would be crystals, sacred geometry, whatever the fuck you need to balance out the equation, the chakra in your life in that moment is what's gonna add to it, okay? So with that being said, let's think about cooking, okay? Whether you cook or not, you should be able to understand this. When we're cooking, we have something that we want to make and you want it to taste good. You're gonna need seasoning, garlic, onion. You're gonna need things that mix well to make your dish taste the way you want it, okay? If I didn't want something salty, why would I put a bunch of salt in it? Does that kind of make sense? That doesn't mix. Salt might be, yes, a seasoning for food, and I might be making food, yes, but it's not the right energy that I need to put in it for that situation, okay? And so as you start to learn about the chakras, about the world, you can start mixing things in to amplify the energy. The world, this entire world is our playground. Everything in this goddamn universe is for us to use. Everything in this universe is at our disposal to use, to call upon. What I mean by that is, okay, so I got a problem. I got a root chakra problem. I'm gonna put everything that I know, everything that I've been learning that is associated with balancing the root chakra, I'm gonna put it into this pot. This pot represents my life, and hopefully all of the energies that I just mixed in there will help give me a balanced equation, a balanced issue to where it's not an issue anymore. So, okay, I got a root chakra problem. Let me throw in some color therapy. Let me wear the color red, okay? Oh, but that's not enough because my issue is a little bigger than that. All right, so what else does the root chakra have to deal with? Oh, mantras. That's sound. Sound carries certain frequencies. Speaking intentional thoughts over your life, that you're casting spells, bro. Sound frequencies create the reality that you're trying to create. So the mantra for the root chakra is Lam. I mean, not saying it once, but if you sit down and meditate, Lam, wearing the color red, that's two energies that have to do with the root chakra. You still not feeling balanced? Okay, let's do something else. What else has to deal with the root chakra? Ah, let me get my crystals that have to deal with the root chakra. Let me get crystals that are gonna help balance me. Let me put that into my pot. Oh, okay, but crystals aren't crazy big. You know, maybe this problem is bigger than me. I need more. Or not even that I need more, I just wanna make sure this works. So I'm gonna put more into it, I'm gonna learn more about it. When I say everything gives off a certain energy, the days of the week give off a certain energy, bro. Do something on a certain day that has to deal with the root chakra. I would tell you right now, but I just don't know, so I might pop it up on the screen. But I can tell you, if you're really good and learning about astrology, I'm not crazy good in astrology, but I'll tell you, planets that are associated with the root chakra, Mars, Pluto, Saturn. I believe they have days that are associated like a Mars day. Just for the sake of this video, let's say Mars day is on Tuesday. On Tuesday, I'm going to sit down, meditate, and say, I'm gonna sit down with my crystals with the intention of balancing my root chakra while wearing my red robe, okay? Something else, zodiacs. The zodiacs that are associated with the root chakra, Taurus, Aries, Scorpio, and Capricorn. I'm a Taurus. I can pull that energy out of me and be like, okay, Taurus energy, let's go. We need to balance this root chakra. And I could sit there and I could meditate on balancing the root chakra in the energy of Taurus. When a planet is in the sign of Taurus, when a planet is in the sign of Aries, when a planet is in the sign of Scorpio, when a planet is in the sign of Capricorn, on those days, whenever a planet is in that sign, I can be like, oh, take that energy, pop it in my pot. Let's sit there. I mean, I'm not really doing it, but the fact that I had the intention and I knew this, I can pull that energy now. Mix it in my pot. Oh shoot, now my pot's getting a little bit heavier. We got a little more energy coming out of this pot. What else can I do to balance this root chakra? Food. Foods associated with the root chakra, root vegetables and protein-rich foods. This is when it comes to food, yes, you can do that, but again, intention. And this is gonna be something kind of religious. You know how you say prayer over your food? All you're doing is setting an intention over that food. You're sending energy towards that food. You are sending a certain energy that when you eat that food, that energy is now in there. That's why when it says made with love, food made with love. Yes, yes the fuck it was, and I feel great. Whether you're religious or not, let's talk about prayer. There's a prayer when I was Christian, you know, we'd have to pray over our food, Jesus wept. But there's this one, bless this food for which we are about to receive for the nourishment of our body in Christ's sake, Christ's name, amen. Bless this food for which I am about to receive for the nourishment of my body. Prayer over your food. Bless this drink for the nourishment of my body, for Christ's sake, amen. I drink it. I just sent intention. I want y'all to literally have a kid-like mindset. When you speak, pretend like there is energy, there is magic coming out of that and sending it into it. Whoop, I spilled, but food. Put that in my pot, my root chakra pot. The more energies that are associated with a certain with the same energy, the more you're amplifying it and the stronger it's going to be, the better it'll work. Not saying you have to do all of this, but you can, and I'm gonna tell you. Chakra size. Exercise for the chakras. If the root chakra has to deal with grounding, chakra size could be marching, stomping, doing squats, because the chakra is kind of somewhere between there, but chakra size. Did you know that your ancestors live within your feet? That's why you gotta take care of your feet. Your ancestors, whether you believe in it or not, but you got people that are rooting for you on the other side. Our feet hold energy, hold ancestral energy. And I can use that information and be like, ancestors, let's go, I need to balance my root chakra. Do you know what I did today? I wasn't feeling too good. And I was talking about the root chakra I was, you know, preparing for this video, I went out and I laid down next to a tree. I laid on the roots of a tree, using the energies of a tree. Trees have powerful energy. And you can do that too.
Let's go do it right now, okay?
When it comes to doing anything in life, man, just have intention.
You have a thought, I want to save money. Okay, that's what's going on.
So if you want to save money, if you set that thought, why are you going out and spending money?
You know what I've been asking myself? Does this action, or does what I want to do, does this action align with my greater purpose? With what I intended? No? Cool. What's next? I'm not doing it.
Going outside and sitting under a tree with the intention of balancing my root chakra, that is aligned with my greater purpose. So that's what I'm going to do. I don't give a fuck if I look crazy doing it.
Sometimes it's best to just take a moment and pause. To end this video, I want to talk about the mudras. We have a lot of energy in our hands. Our hands give off like the most chi. Kind of think of your hands as like magic wands, because if we are the magicians of our own life, I want you to think about a thought being created in your head and being sent through your body and through to your hands, and it just kind of huddles there for a bit, and you send that energy. That's why, like, when people do Reiki energy healing, they're using their hands. Definitely check out the Goop Lab with Gwyneth Paltrow. She has an episode on Reiki, shrooms and everything, and they talk about that and they show it. But right now, the root chakra. So I'm going to show you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mudras, which are hand gestures that you can do with intentional energy sent through them to balance the root chakra. Starting with the root chakra mudra, you're going to take your pinky and thumb, close them together, and meet your ring finger and two fingers sticking up. So this is what I just did. Same thing, pinky and ring finger. Close those two together, and you're going to want to put them by your tailbone or whatever, and you can like meditate with the intentional thought of balancing your root chakra. And you can say lam. You can say it yourself or you can listen to it. It's up to you. Another one, this one is about grounding. You're going to want to extend the index finger and the middle fingers downward to make an inverted V. Curl the pinky and the ring finger inwards, so these two right here, towards the palms, and place the thumb on the fingertips lightly. Extend arms out and bring the tips to the middle and index fingers into the ground and the tops at the tops of the thigh. So this is what we're doing. Most of this you can stand up. I want to show you. So it'd be like this. That one is about grounding. It's called BHU Mudra. The next one we're going to do is fearlessness. Hold right hand slightly cupped at shoulder height, palm facing outwards. Allow the right elbow to fall close to the waist. This mudra is about fearlessness. This also is an energy that can help ground your root chakra. The next one we're going to do is centering. That you can help. Extending both arms outward, touch the tip of the thumbs to the tip of the ring finger. Allow the other fingers to extend straight out, palms facing up. Rest the back of the hands on the thighs and or knees are in the lap. So we would be going like this. Ah. And you can sit and meditate on that, like that. The next one is going to be calming. Open hands wide. Tuck thumbs into the center of the palms. Curl the fingers loosely around the thumbs, making soft fists with both hands. Rest hands, palms on thighs. Lengthen the spine and breathe. Calming. And the last one we're going to do is surrender. Learning about the there's a bug on my computer. Learning about grounding and, you know, getting in tune with the universe is all about surrendering, flowing. Pranihana mudra. I talked about this on my TikTok. This is what you're going to do, bringing the hands together, connecting the tips of the index finger and the pinkies. So, like this. There we go. Surrender. And you're going to want to put that kind of by your waist. Oh, there is a big old bug on my laptop. Anyway, I know that was pretty quick. It's just hot outside. It's like 100 and some odd degrees, so I'm not going to be out here for long. But mudras, definitely check those out. I include those in my chakra readings if I feel like it's needed. Now, I know that video was pretty long, and honestly, it wasn't how I originally wanted it to go, but I just have to start this series. I'm tired of thinking that it has to be one way, so, I mean, as the series goes on, the way my delivery of the information might change, but I hope some of this has helped you. The next chakra is going to be the sacral chakra, one of my faves because it has to do with creativity, so best believe that's going to be a creative-ass video. Anyway, I don't know. There's no point in living for anybody else when we have all the tools to do whatever we want. And I know it sounds crazy, but it is a lot of work in the present moment and realizing what's not working and taking action and moving towards it. Change is scary as shit. Believe me, change is scary as shit. As a Taurus, someone that values their stability, I don't like to just up and move and change. But within that change, we find new things. We meet new people. We experience new things. And I think that is a lot more fun. Remember, life is not about just the end result. It's about the journey going there. If the journey requires change, you best fucking believe it. Change is what I'm welcoming. Remember, everybody, choose kindness, and yeah, bye. Okay.